next guest is kind of a big deal. She is. She's the pastry chef at Yardbird Southern Table and Bar, and her recipes have been featured in, oh, I don't know, the New York Times, maybe People Magazine, and the Wall Street Journal, just to name a few. But today she is here in our kitchen making a perfectly summery peach cobbler. Please welcome back Hedy Goldsmith to our home. Welcome back, Hedy. We're so excited to have you.
To be here.
And as you can see, everyone at the counter is happy to be here as well.
I'm so excited.
Mary and Andrew decided to stick around for this. They were not leaving before they had this ice cream peach cobbler.
That was a good decision.
As well as Walker, Texas Ranger actress Cheri J. Wilson's joining us as well.
Hello, everyone.
Welcome.
The other Walker.
That's right, the other Walker, from one Walker to the next. So peaches are in season right now.
It's the quintessential summer fruit.
It really is. Let's see.
But how do you smell so good?
When I go to know how to choose a perfect peach, because I don't know if you all have this problem, but when I get the peaches, they seem perfect at the grocery store. I love them. By the time I get them home, they're bruised and they've gone bad.
Well, you really have to, you have to pick the peach by its look, by its feel, and by its smell.
Okay.
When you go to the farmer's market, you can always ask the farmer which one is the ripest one for you. But if you go, you want to smell the fruit. You want to make sure it has that fragrant, peachy smell.
Okay.
Then you'll know that the sugar's really developed. And you want to have it unblemished, and you want to just feel it. It's got to give a little bit.
But not too smushy.
Not too smushy. You don't want smushy unless you're going to make ice cream.
Like mealy peaches. Those are the worst.
Oh, I get
bite into
so
it, and it's just it's soft.
It's so disappointing.
Everything about the exterior is perfect, but then
I know, and then you get inside.
We're
and it's
picking
not what you're
perfect
expecting.
Peaches, and we're going to bake perfect
so
peaches.
So we did. We picked perfect peaches.
How?
We peeled them, and we've taken the pits out, and we put them in a bowl. So what else?
Exactly.
Do we
what we're going to do is we're going to add some granulated sugar to it.
Okay. Regular
okay,
sugar.
Regular sugar. There you go. You know, peaches are inherently sweet because we're going to use ripe fruit. A little bit of cinnamon,
nice,
because
like
we can, and cinnamon's delicious. It brings out all the flavors, right, folks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Little bit of vanilla extract.
I love vanilla extract as well.
Smells
so
great.
Good.
It's so fragrant. A little bit of salt. You know, folks are afraid to put salt in dessert. Salt's really important. It brings all those flavors together.
It brightens it.
It does. It brightens it exactly. And a little bit of cornstarch.
Oh,
what
okay.
this is going to do, as the peaches bake, it's going to pull all those delicious, juicy flavors together into a great sauce.
Now, we have to let our peaches rest. Why are they so tired?
Well, what? They're exhausted from a long day at the farm. Actually, what we want to do is we want to let them rest so all the flavors kind of meld together.
Okay.
It's called macerating.
Oh, so macerating.
Okay. It's a big word.
It's a big fancy word for just resting.
I like resting.
Okay, so we'll set those aside and let them rest. In the meantime, we're going to make the delicious cookie crumble that
well,
we put on top.
This is the key. I mean, you have great fruit, but this is really the icing on the cake.
It really
so to speak.
Is.
Eddie, I'm from Georgia, and I've had many. A peach cobbler. This is hands down the best peach cobbler
I mean, I think the New York Times agrees. I think the Wall Street Journal agrees.
My grandmother has never been to the New York Times, and now I understand why.
I love that. Well, you know,
you're done.
It's the peach capital of the world.
It is.
God.
That's true. So in here, we have cream, some butter, and some sugar.
We have.
What else are we going to add?
What we want to do is we want to make it nice and light and fluffy because it's going to make a really nice cookie crust. So we're going to get this.
This is going. You want to put something else in?
Yeah, we're going to add an egg yolk to it.
And I'll get it going. There we go.
Yeah. Okay, so at that point, what we want to do is we want to see that the egg yolk comes together.
Right.
We're going to add a little bit of almond extract.
Almond
this
extract.
This is the trick.
That's
almonds
secret.
And peaches. Wow, it makes a great combination. And then
what if
we'll
you didn't have almonds? Could you use
vanilla?
You
could use vanilla extract. Absolutely.
Okay. Oh my goodness, that smell. Oh,
and, right? It's fantastic. And then we're going to slow this down a little bit, and we're going to add our flour. That's going to come together, and it's going to be our cookie dough.
Okay.
And we're going to shut this off. What we'll do is we'll pull this up and we'll get...
Take the hook off.
Yeah.
And that's it.
And basically that's it.
Oh, so it doesn't have to come together that much, does it?
No, not really. Cookies, you know, you don't want to mix it too much because then it gets a little bit tough.
Okay.
You know, tough cookie.
Yeah, right.
You know, it may be good for certain things, but not for a peach cobbler.
No, it's not.
Right, folks?
Right, right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is just for the last second or two, just to get it combined.
Oh, that's I would have thought you really needed to get more in there.
No,
all right.
No, not at all. So you've got this really great smelling cookie topping. And
do I put this in here and then you put it on top?
Put those peaches right
all
in there. And we'll take spoonfuls of this topping.
Use those muscles.
How long should they be?
Look at those arms.
I know. How long should,
that's impressive.
Should the maceration, how long?
Really impressive. Just as long as it takes to make your topping, that's fine. Okay. Absolutely.
There we go.
Because the peaches have so much inherent flavor. Mm. So what we're going to do is we're going to take spoonfuls of this, and we're going to drop spoonfuls
just like
of
that.
This. Yeah, you can do
just
that.
Just all over?
All over.
Yum.
Yeah. Nice. Exactly. You know, cobblers have different toppings. They have streusel, they have cookie topping, biscuit topping, but I found that this is really the best way to highlight the peaches.
And let them show through.
Yeah.
Now, as a pastry chef, mm-hmm. I know butter is very controversial.
Not in my world.
Well, the reason I ask is, when you make your, not use it, I love butter. But I mean, when you're baking, do you use butter with salt or without salt?
I use unsalted butter because I can control the salt.
Okay.
I don't know how much butter the manufacturers are putting into the butter.
How much salt,
how much salt. So I like to control it.
And is there a specific butter you like?
Well, am I allowed to say?
Well, you know what? Probably you'll tell me off camera.
Okay, I will.
Absolutely. For me.
Absolutely. So we're going to do 45 minutes, and we're going to really look at it and make sure that it has this bubbly, gorgeous note to it. You want to have the cookie crust a little bit. There you go.
Oh my goodness.
And there you go.
I can't
peach
wait to
cobbler. Get in
there. That looks that was pretty easy. You made it,
was,
it look easy.
Right?
Oh. I want some more.
Oh my gosh.
So, Hedy, your restaurant, Yardbird.
Yes.
So you have this on the menu.
Yes. This is one of those recipes that Yardbird's known for, their peach cobbler.
And they also are known for its southern food, right?
Which southern
is right
food.
Out of my alley, girl.
Fried chicken, the best fried chicken I think in the world. But
I agree.
Really?
I agree. It's so
fried chicken, waffles, biscuits. All kinds of good
stuff. You said it. You said it with biscuits. It is so beautiful. And then, of course, we put ice cream on top.
Well, you have to. I mean, that's really a la mode.
Eating guys. Wow, Hedy. I mean, this may be a difficult question for you, but of all the desserts in the world out there that you've made or maybe someone else has made, what is your favorite?
Oh, that's a tricky question.
I know it's hard to
ask.
You know,
that really is a tricky question. I love anything with ice cream and sorbet. So I'll leave it like that.
That's
fair. Absolutely.
All right, Hedy, you ready?
He's a growing
I'm ready.
Let's get in here.
Okay.
He's fit. Taste
get
the fruits
ready,
of your
Daddy.
Labor.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Insane.
That's all I got to say about that.
Oh my God.
I need to macerate for a few minutes.